This report comes at an incredibly crucial time for the Asia Pacific and indeed the world and the global malaria fight. On the one hand, here in Asia, the fight advances towards malaria elimination. But on the other hand, it has to combat the threat of drug resistance.
I think the concern around the ability to eliminate vivax, relapsing malaria, was surprising and a bit of a wake-up call in terms of our need to improve the messaging, but also to improve the speed at which we tackle that challenge.
We see that there are a lot of issues and concerns with mobile migrant populations around cross-border collaboration and cross-border work, so I hope that would be one of the areas that they can focus on in the future for malaria elimination efforts.
The next question from the report is, how do we achieve this elimination? And particularly since the populations that we need to reach are difficult to reach and migrant populations. And that will need us to collaborate very differently than before, both cross-sectorally, so public, private, NGO, and also cross-border.
I hope our report will help all involved in our efforts to end malaria and to find the best strategies and operations in our future work, which remains a very challenging task.
We all of the partners here, have an essential role to play to ensure that nobody in the Asia Pacific dies from a mosquito bite.
The area that private sector can add most is innovation, to really explore new ways of solving some of these big problems.
It was really great to see the panel so engaged and the audience so engaged on a bunch of really key issues of the day, right? Drug resistance, universal healthcare, training of healthcare workers, and to have the study tell us what people in the field are thinking at the local level, what are their perceptions of the malaria fight, and what do they need from us as a community, I think was really empowering.